Hey guys, welcome to Protocoders Point. Okay, so in this photo tutorial, we're gonna implement how to check if your device is connected to internet. And if your device is connected to internet, which type of network it has been using, whether it is a Wi-Fi or it is a mobile network. Okay, so to achieve this, we are going to make use of a library called as connectivity that helps us in doing this. And for state management, we are going to make use of GetX package. So let's begin. So here I have created a simple demo app for demonstration. So now you can see there is a no internet, and when I just on mobile data, you can see you are connected to mobile internet. And now I will just on my Wi-Fi, let it get connected. Okay, so as you can see, as soon as it got connected, you got a status in your app that you are connected to Wi-Fi. I will just off it now, so you can see no internet. So let's implement it. Okay, so let's go to our Android Studio IDE. So here I have created a new photo project by name GetX Check Internet, and I have removed all the default code, the counter code that has been given by photo team while creating new photo project, and I have replaced the code with my own stateful widget. For now, it simply has a scaffold widget with a column, and there is no any widget over here. We are going to add it now. Okay, so first of all, just go to pubspecification.yaml file, and under dependency section over here, add a library that is get, and second library we need, that is connectivity. Okay, so add these two libraries. You can keep the version as empty. It will take the latest version. So after adding that, just hit the pubget button. Okay, so now let's create a new file, dart file, that is getx. I can name it as getx network manager. Okay, so this dart file will manage our network state by making use of getx state management. Okay, so here create a class, and I will name it as getx network manager, and that extends getx controller. Okay, so here we need two overriding methods, so just import it. The one is on init and second one is on close. We need both of these. Okay, so this file will help us in getting our network state. So let's create some variables over here. Here I will just create a variable connection type. Okay, so which is of type integer. For initially we will set it to 0. Okay, so we will use this variable in such a way that if it is 0, then it means that the device is not connected to internet. If it is 1, then your device is connected to Wi-Fi. And if it is 2, then your device is connected to mobile data. Okay, so initially we will set it to 0, that is no internet connected. And then here we will create an instance of connectivity. Okay, so this will help us in getting the type of connection the device is connected. So in your init method, here on init, here we will just create a function. We can name it as get connection type. Okay, so let's create a method over here somewhere. I will just copy this method name and paste it over here, and then in this method we are going to create a variable connection result, connectivity result. Okay, and then here we are going to make use of try and catch. Okay, so here we are going to make use of try and catch because sometimes the connectivity result may fail to get the data in some platform, Android or iOS or web. Okay, so we are just wrapping it into a try and catch. So here connectivity result is equal to await, and then here just make use of connectivity dot check connection. Okay, so as we are making use of await, we must make this method as asynchronization. Okay, and future void. Okay, so now we have if your device is connected to internet or no. Okay, so hence we will just return from here. We can just return connectivity state, or else I will just create a update method connectivity result. Okay, so we got our connect type of connection, so we will just create one more method, update state, that will check which type of data connection it is. Okay, so now here update state connectivity result. So now here we will make use of switch statement, switch result. Here first case we will check connectivity result dot is, if it is Wi-Fi. If it is Wi-Fi, then we will change our variable to 1. Okay, and then update the consumer of this variable, and then just break the case. Okay, so I will just copy the case and I will change this connectivity result to mobile. If it is mobile, then we are going to change it to 2. If it is none, then we are changing it back to 0, and then update. So here it is showing me an error. Okay, so I need to just break the case. Okay, and then we will just make use of default. In default means if there is a error in getting the data, we can just show the sneaky bar network error. So we are done. Here what we are doing is we are calling this, we are creating an instance of this from our main.dat file. We will do it now. And here what is happening is we have a variable to check if it is connected to internet, if it is connected to Wi-Fi, or if it is connected to mobile device. And then we have created an instance of connectivity of this library connectivity, and by making use of it we are just getting the type of connection, and then simply we are passing the result of this to another method. In this we have a switch statement. If it is connected to Wi-Fi, then we are changing the data to 1, and then if it is connected to mobile, then we are changing to mobile, and if it is connected to none, means there is no internet, then we are changing it back to 0. Okay, so that's it in this file. So let's go to main.dat file. Okay, so here we need to change this material app to get material, and just import get.dart package. Okay, so now here this method, this widget need initial binding. Okay, so let's create a initial binding for this widget. Create a new dart file and we will name it as network binding. Then here just create a class network binding, extend binding. Okay, so now here you need to override one method, that is dependency, and inside this we will make use of getX dot lazy put, and here we will put our getX network manager. okay, and then you need to typecast this method. So here you need to typecast to GetText network manager. Okay, so now in your main.dart file you need to just call this network binding. Yes, it's done. So now whenever your app get restarted, what will happen is your GetText app manager will call network state, and then network binding will get the data from this network manager, GetText network manager, and this code will work. Okay, and this network initial binding will just keep update of your network. For example, if your network goes off and if you are connected to Wi-Fi and they get disconnected, so this network binding will get updated. Okay, so now let's show our network status in your app UI. So here I will just create a text widget. Okay, and then second widget, what I need is I need to get this variable. I need to use this variable in our second widget. So for that, first of all, we will just create an instance of this page, GetText network manager page. So for that, final GetText network manager, we will name it as network manager get.find. And what we need to find is our GetText manager, that is GetText network state manager. Yeah, okay. So now you can use this to fetch the data of this page. Now here what I will do is I will just make use of GetText builder. Text widget. Inside this GetText builder, I will show a text widget that is dollar network manager dot network type. Okay, so now let's restart our app. Okay, sorry. Here I need you change the font size. Just restart our app again. Okay, so I have just added a typecasting over here. Just update it. Okay, so our app is running. So now you can see the status is zero. So I will just connect to my mobile data. So it is not getting updated because we need to make use of one more code to update the status of your app. So for that, here in GetText network manager, here what we need to use is let stream subscription, stream subscription. And then here after this method here, stream subscription is equal to connectivity dot on connectivity change dot listen, and we need to call our update status method. Okay, so now what is happening over here is whenever our network state changes, our update state get called. Okay, so I'll just refresh the app again. Okay, I need to restart the app for that. Okay, so our app got reinstalled. So now I'll just change the status of the mobile data. So you can see the status is zero. Now I will just connect to Wi-Fi.
So as soon as this it get connected, your network state will get updated. Let's wait. Okay, so as you see, our mobile device is connected to network. So you can see the state, it is 1. So 1 means it is connected to Wi-Fi. Okay, so let's change the UI. So instead of showing the simple number, we will show some text message. Okay, so for that, here network manager dot connectivity. If it is equal to 0, then we will show a message no internet. And if it is not connected, if it has a connection, then we will check one more condition, that is network manager dot connectivity state. If it is equal to 1, that means if it is 1, that is it is connected to Wi-Fi. Okay, and if it is not connected to Wi-Fi, then it means that it is connected to mobile data. Okay, so let's restart our app. Okay, so as you can see, you are connected to Wi-Fi. So I will just off the Wi-Fi. So you can see no internet. I will just on the mobile data. So you can see you are connected to mobile internet. Okay, so that's all for this video tutorial. Hope you got the concept of how to implement network connectivity with GetText state management. So please do subscribe Protocol Orders Point. Thank you.